you know, chess used to be before, I think, Alpha Chess, or maybe the latest version of Stockfish, the best chess programs were like, you know, these hybrid systems with the human in the loop. But then at some point, you know, the AI got good enough that the human in the loop only messes things up, right? I mean, do you ever have cases where you think that the ML system works better than a human operator, and maybe it shouldn't actually give the final decision to a doctor?
It's a great question. I think, as I said before, generally speaking, it's not that hard. Well, I mean, it's taking us a few years, but it's not, quote unquote, that hard to get an algorithm that is better than the average physician. Now, that being said, it's much harder to get an algorithm that it's better than the combination of the human plus the AI. So even in the examples that you're mentioning, you know, the combination of humans plus AI in chess, if the human is relatively good, meaning a professional player, it's hard to beat, right? So an AI alone versus a combination of AI plus human, it's hard to beat. But in the case of healthcare, one of the important things to understand is that it is an imperfect information game, right? So it's not about, if you had the perfect information, the algorithm would probably always beat the human, right? And you would be very easy to just beat the human with sort of like all the perfect information in the world. However, in the case of medicine and healthcare, there's a lot that goes on with empathizing with the patient, understanding even, you know, things that are called like social determinants. Where do they come from? How are they going to understand? How can you communicate the possibility of something being likely or not? And that it's very hard to do if you're not a human that is trained to have this level of empathy, so to speak, right? So there's the interesting question, and I keep talking to people that have very different opinions with that, right? Like, there is the purely extreme rational opinion that all you want to have from the outcome as a patient is have a list of possible diagnoses with a probability, and you'll be able to interpret them. And that's, you know, if you're a hyper-rational person, that is true. You want to know if you have a 0.2% probability of having cancer, you want to know that there's a 0.2 probability, and you think you can deal with it. The reality is that most people don't know how to interpret that, right? Like, what does that even mean, a 0.2 probability of having cancer? And do you want to communicate that, or do you want to interpret that and then follow the patient along and make sure that that probability doesn't get to a point that is more likely than not? And I think that's where the human judgment is really key, and that's very different from a pure probability that is output from any kind of machine learning algorithm.
If you're enjoying Gradient Dissent, I'd really love for you to check out Fully Connected, which is an inclusive machine learning community that we're building to let everyone know about all the stuff going on in ML and all the new research coming out. If you go to wmb.ai/FC, you can see all the different stuff that we do, including Gradient Dissent, but also salons where we talk about new research and folks share insights, AMAs where you can directly connect with members of our community, and a Slack channel where you can get answers to everything from very basic questions about ML to bug reports on weights and biases to how to hire an ML team. We're looking forward to meeting you.